What's up, y'all? Talent here. Today we're going to be taking one of the strongest Kyogre teams in the metagame for a spin on the Battle Stadium ladder, but before we do that, this is a recreation of the number one Battle Stadium ranking team from June, of my own recreation. So basically, this team was piloted by Crystal, Jeongso Lee. He was able to get number one and number three on the ladder. I think he was like literally one win away from getting number one and number two on the ladder on two different carts. So really impressive finish with a very consistent team with a lot of very interesting picks. So Jeongso did not release the team publicly, but did release the open team sheet as well as competed with it in a online tournament, getting ninth place in the $2,000 Victory Road Road to Honolulu Tour, going 9-1 in Swiss. So definitely very proven in both closed team sheet and open team sheet, so very excited to be featuring it on the channel. If you want to use the team for yourself, of course, rental code in the top right, pokey paste in the description below. And with all that being said, if you guys enjoy the videos, please subscribe, and let's introduce the team a little bit more thoroughly now. So the biggest thing that jumps out here is it is obviously a Kyogre that is the restricted on this team, but this one, we've seen a lot of Assault Vest defensive, we've seen Choice Scarf, Choice Specs variants, but this one is an entirely different one with no Water Spout, conventionally seen as Kyogre's strongest move. Instead, just opting for only Origin Pulse, Ice Beam, and then Calm Mind Protect. Very interesting. Calm Mind, Terra Grass, basically just trying to opt for a very defensive set. You don't want to get Spored, you don't want to get Wood Hammered by opposing Rillaboom. So having that Terra Grass is really just buffs you up defensively, as well as means you're not weak to Electric-type moves. Some Rhydon's a lot easier to wall after a Calm Mind or two. And then Protect with the Leftovers and Grassy Terrain from really Rillabooms. Grassy Surge is definitely very appreciated. You can stall up to 24... percent of your HP between two turns by just like getting the passive healing from that and one Protect. So that is very appreciated, especially when you have the bulk from the Grimmsnarl's Light Screen, Reflect, and Spirit Break, as well as just generally being very pesky with Thunder Wave. Kyogre has a bit of speed on it, so you're able to outspeed things like Calyrex Shadow Rider after the Thunder Wave, so that speed control can be very nice if you get it off against your opponent early in the game. Battles tend to be very long when you're using a Kyogre team like this, with Calm Mind, Double Fake Out, Amoongus, multiple screens, so having the option to have the Light Clay to extend the screens makes a lot of sense, as well as having the Thunder Wave. If you get that off early in the battle, not only is the speed control going to be very important for you, but as the battle drags on longer and longer, the more likely it is that your opponent will continue to get paralyzed and lose very valuable turns, and you can overwhelm them in that way pretty quickly. And when things are not paralyzed, you can go for Spore against them. That's definitely very appreciated. You have a lot of Fake Out on the team. As we have said, the Incineroar plus the Rillaboom give you options to Fake Out Spore things. Rage Powder to protect that Kyogre and their offensive Raging Bolt, also very appreciated. And Pollen Puff whenever the Grassy Terrain healing isn't enough, or you just want to have a spare turn where your opponent is kind of defensively or offensively out of position, you can Pollen Puff one of your sweepers or even your supports back up to full HP with the Pollen Puff. Raging Bolt is going to be your secondary source of offense here with the Magnet, Tera Electric. Outside of that, the rest of the team is pretty standard. Will-O-Wisp and Incineroar with Safety Goggles and Assault Vest U-Turn Rillaboom. Basically, the pivoting combination of Parting Shot, Fake Out Incineroar, and then the Fake Out U-Turn on the Rillaboom just means it's very easy for you to get many Calm Minds up on your Kyogre and just overwhelm your opponent through multiple turns of just sustained offense that way. So it's a very cool team. Congratulations to Jeongso on the ninth place finish at the VR Challenge, the Honolulu $2,000 tournament. Ultimately fell just a little outside of the money, but also a very impressive ladder finish with first and third place in the June battle season. So yeah, if you guys want to check out Jeongso on Twitter, they go by Crystal. I have that in the description. Of course, the Pokeface with my EVs and a rental code is in the top right of the video. If you guys enjoy these type of videos, please subscribe to the channel. And with all that being said, let's hop into it. Oh my goodness. Is that fully evolved? I truly couldn't tell. I forget. Is it Blitzel and Zebstrika? I know Zebstrika is the other one. I think that gets Lightning Rod, I want to say. I'm not entirely sure. Yeah, that's crazy. Okay. Well, anyways, it is a Zamazenta team. I do think getting a Thunder Wave or a screen up can be really appreciated here. So I'm going to lead with the Kyogre and the Grimmsnarl. Heavy Slam will do a lot, but you know, after I get Reflect up, that could be worth it. Incineroar seems pretty decent. I do have reason to worry about the... if I can get Rain up... I'm considering no Fake Out in the back, but I'm not sure if that's a mistake or not. With Rain Up, I deal very well with the Volcarona if they are not a Terra Dark. If they're not Terra Grass, but they very easily could be. The question is, I think Raging Bolt or Incineroar for me here. I think Zebstrika is kind of annoying. If it's like Supercell Slam, I might have to commit early to a Terra Grass. We'll see about that. But their Iron Defense, if I can paralyze the Zamazenta, that's going to be nice. So I think... Yeah, I'm going to go with the Raging Bolt just because I feel like the... I don't know. I think Chienpao having two... Chienpao could be annoying because I might be forced to go for Terra Grass, and then the Chienpao then hits all my Pokemon but Grimmsnarl for super effective with an Ice move, so that's like maybe not great. So it probably should have been Incineroar and just lean extremely hard on my Kyogre's offense, but didn't go for that here. Screens should be pretty important, but I could also go for a Thunder Wave early. Okay, that's kind of interesting. I think Heavy Slam will knock me out, but I kind of just want to go for a Calm Mind plus Thunder Wave here, I want to say. Booster Energy... What do you got? Speed. Okay, that's fine. I think I'm going to Thunder Wave them, because if I can outspeed them, that's really nice. Speed Boost, I can always kind of just like deal with the... Basically, if I get a para on the Zamazenta, I'm doing very well here, and they might just double up into my... Okay, they're going for a Tera right off the bat. That's interesting. Okay, Zama is going for the Tera, and it is Tera Water. Okay, so they kind of wall me, but after getting the para off here, it's really nice for my Raging Bolt, I think. Because if I can get a Spore off onto the Walking Wake, I'm kind of chilling. So glad I went for the Thunder Wave. That makes the Zamazenta way easier to clear out later on. I will always outspeed that with a Thunderbolt. It is Snarl, which is annoying, but with the Calm Mind, I think that's fine. I would have survived the turn if I had gone for Reflect Guaranteed, though, so I don't know. You know, hard to say what's better here. The problem is if I Thunder Wave the Body Press, that's fine. Body Press, that's not fine. Okay, the crit's kind of annoying, but it is what it is. I kind of have to switch out now, unfortunately. I can pretty easily just go for Reflect, I think, and then maybe get a Pollen Puff off later. If they Body Press into my Kyogre, I won't be able to do that as easily. No terrain's kind of an issue, but I can Protect Switch. Because if they're going for Heavy Slam into Grimmsnarl, that's fine by me. They're switching out. Interesting. Okay. Very interesting. I could have gotten Reflect up here, but it might just be Chienpao. Zebstrika, okay, interesting. A lot of unexpected stuff going on here. They forfeit their booster energy, but I guess they wanted a Lightning Rod proc or something like that. Fine by me, I get a little bit of HP on the Kyogre, and if they are not... They get paralyzed, okay. Heavy Slam would have done some damage into the Emunga, so I don't hate that, definitely. But I think this is going to be a... I kind of want to Spore Zebstrika. It's probably an electric move here, I think. I don't want to lose my Kyogre necessarily. And if I get the Spore off, I should be able to Pollen Puff myself. I could switch out into the Grimmsnarl and get a screen up, but that's so passive, I don't love it necessarily. Yeah, the Body Press crit was just a lot of damage. Wasn't expecting that, obviously. You know, 23 out of 24, but it's not the end of the world because we did survive. It's still playable. Ooh, okay, Taunt Zebstrika is really annoying. Interesting, okay. Alright, Body Press. That being a 2-KO is really bad. Man, Reflect going up would have been really good. Yeah, this is getting very tricky. To win without a paralysis. I think Zebstrika does get... Zebras are kind of horses, right? I think Zebstrika gets high horsepower, surely. So they can just hit me with that, unfortunately. Zebstrika does get Lightning Rod. Yikes. Okay. That's super unfortunate. I kind of have to break a Focus Sash or something like that. I'm just like switching around and getting knocked out slowly but surely, unfortunately. Yikes, man. Rage Powder Origin Pulse would have been great. Unfortunate. Yeah, I'm just switching around and letting them take KOs, but if I could have gotten a Spore off, that would have been really good. I could have maybe gotten a Pollen Puff off. Although they're always just gonna be hitting me too hard. Eerie Impulse. Not even attacking is kind of questionable, but whatever. This gives me an opportunity to get a Reflect up. Boom, another big hit. They have done so much damage with Body Press, and I have not really answered back. Yikes. Really looking bad here. I could sack something. I don't think that's good by any means. Yeah, this is just super bad. I could Tera, but they should just Heavy Slam me, I think. I might just have to rip it, though. I don't know. This is all looking pretty horrible for me. Yeah, I guess I have to hope they don't have Heavy Slam for some reason. But there's no indication that that's the case at this point. And maybe they go for Heavy Slam, just like, or Body Press trying to do good coverage into my Kyogre in the back, which maybe could live a Heavy Slam, or more likely my Raging Bolt, but it's looking pretty bad. Looking very, very bad. There's the taunt, fair enough. I do get the Reflect up first. Very crazy Zebstrika set. Iron Defense, I guess that's fine, because once I clear out the Zebstrika, I can maybe figure this out. The healing's good, now they can't hit me quite easily. And taunt should wear out this turn, maybe? No? Yeah, cool. So I think this is a... Honestly, I maybe just double into the Zebstrika, get that off the field so that I can Thunderclap stuff later on. I think I will do that. Should I sack Kyogre at this point? Maybe. Should I get it to full HP? Would I live a Heavy Slam? That's the question. I think they're going to taunt the Amoongus, truthfully. This is pretty aggressive. I could go for a Spirit Break Protect fairly safely. If they finally attack in my Grimmsnarl, I'm in some trouble. But I think a taunt's way more likely. If they read me this turn, so be it. Taunt, cool. They have to... I don't know what they're going for. They get paralyzed, that's why we go for it. Who knows what they went for, but we are healing all the way back up. Very nice. Cool. So now we can go for... I mean, they probably knock me out. Maybe not. I do have a lot of bulk, and we probably knock them out with Origin Pulse, I think. So that's pretty cool. If I can paralyze their Raging Bolt, I'm in a good spot later on. I'm going to go for Origin Pulse here. Let them knock out my Kyogre, I think. Yeah, they are the Iron Defense set. This is a crazy first game. Super kind of indicative of what you're likely to see with this team. It's just a lot of stall. Origin, Eerie Impulse, not even attacking. That's crazy. I think I might even knock out the Zebstrika if I hit. But it looks like we unfortunately missed. Yeah, that's the one we wanted to hit, so that stinks. Did all that healing for Kyogre to miss an Origin Pulse, which can be the case. You know, one of the things about this, you're kind of just playing to get as many attacks off as you can. And we only went for one Origin Pulse and we missed one, so if you're able to go for multiple Origin Pulses over the course of the battle, it can tend to even out if you miss one or two, but we're not able to accomplish that here. So this is a big problem, the Eerie Impulse specifically. It's going to be very hard to deal with this guy. Their safety goggles were kind of cooked, I want to say. Maybe this knocks out, I don't know. This is just looking very, very horrible. Maybe we can bait them a bit, but they could probably win on timer themselves. This is all just pretty miserable spot. The Zebstrike is so annoying. With Taunt Eerie Impulse, I wasn't expecting it. It could just as easily be a Thundurus, but Thundurus cannot block me out from going for Thunderclaps. So, really smart team building choice from them. Okay, should have gone for the Thunder for the Spirit Break a couple turns ago, but it is what it is. Body Press into the Amoongus. Gonna do a lot, but not that much damage through Reflect, truthfully. I want this knockout on the Zebstrika, so I'm just gonna protect the Amoongus. And see what they switch into. It's probably Chen Pao in the back, but Volcarona at this point would be a pretty solid Pokemon for them. Okay, they finally reveal another move, it's Protect. Wonder what their last move is. So I wasn't really threatening much on their Zamazenta here, so solid Protect, for sure. Now they can kind of double into me and I don't have a whole lot I can do about it. Yep, there's the Iron Defense. Good play. And it's looking kind of dicey. Like, Chen Pao in the back is going to be tough to beat. Let's just go for Spirit Break, and... I guess I kind of have to Pollen Puff myself. No. It's going to be very hard to win this battle against a Chen Pao in the back. Yeah, I'm just going to go for a... Thunderclap should always deal with the Zamazenta, I want to say. So I'll just heal up the Grimmsnarl, I suppose. I could Spore the Zama, or the Zebstrika with Spirit Break. Yeah, that was my better play. Just because it covers the switch out pretty well. Into something like Volc if they have that. But it is that. Interesting that they would have let me put that to sleep. Fine by me. Oh, wait, I think crit the Spirit Break. I'll definitely take that after missing the Zebstrika with the Origin Pulse. And getting crit first turn. So we've evened up the Pokemon count, and we do have the Para active. That is what happens on this team, is you do have that opportunity. And we heal back up to full. Interesting. If we can clear out the Zebstrika, we're kind of in a good spot. Rain is stopping, so that's annoying. Volcarona at this point would be a bit of a problem. But maybe with Light Screen we could live a fire move. Okay, that is going to be the Zebstrika. I'm probably just going Spirit Break regardless, though. Two more turns of that. Yeah. Could try and switch out, I don't think that's right. I think I Spirit Break here and most likely protect. Or do I attack? I think they have a very easy protect on their end, unfortunately. And I can't do a whole lot about it. Let me just get a bit of chip off, I want to say. Protect is fine. Oh, they're just doubling out. Fair enough. Yeah, I could have scored that. So they're playing really defensive with the Zebstrika. They know I have the Raging Bolt in the back, so it makes sense. Chen Pao's not going to love taking this, and with Rocky Helmet Chip, we have some game here. Because I'm going to bring them down to Focus Sash. This is definitely starting to get playable. Very playable indeed. Oh, that does less than I expected. We get another para, very appreciated, of course, and now what do we do? Probably, I think they protect the Chen Pao 100%, but in the case that they don't... I can't really get the Raging Bolt in very safely is the problem. That's for sure an issue. I could just Rage Powder here. I think I might want to do that. Just Rage Powder switch. Because it's very likely they're going to go for a Protect. So I want to cover for that. I guess my better play here would be Pollen Puff into my Raging Bolt. If I'm going to read the Protect here, but yeah, they Protect. So this was potentially an opportunity, but I didn't want them to go for a crazy Body Press read and win it off that. They get parried again. That is why you use Thunder Wave. It's just a very broken move over the course of a long battle. Reflect wears off, unfortunately. That might actually be very devastating for me. I think this should just be a Draco Meteor Rage Powder, though. Ah, this is kind of a read, right? I think they're going to switch into the Zebstrika here. So in that circumstance, I should probably just go for Rage Powder. I don't know, though. They could go for Protect fairly easily, and then I'm, like, not winning the game, I think. Okay, we do catch them, which means we're going to knock out the Zebstrika, and later in the game we'll be able to hit that Thunderbolt if we have the Amoongus on the field pretty safely. Let's see what we get. We did definitely get into a situation where we can actually win the game because of the many Thunder Waves, but this was definitely a very RNG-influenced matchup, which, you know, you have Origin Pulse, you have multiple... very long battles with the Thunder Wave, so this type of thing can come about. And they get paired again. That is crazy. Crazy luck on my side. So at this point, if I get Reflect up, I think I do just, like, potentially win. I might also win on Timer here. Not super exciting to see, but I think we might have that. Yeah, that was... really annoying Zebstrika play from them had me like on the back foot, as well as missing the attack on it earlier, but we have clawed our way into a fairly decent position. If they're not Throat Chop on the Chen Pao, they're going to really struggle to win this game, I think. Yeah, especially with them burning Protect here, I should have Rage Powder Spirit Break fairly safely to close the game. I could go for Reflect plus Rage Powder, but I don't think that's necessary, and they Body Press into the Amoongus. Cool. So, I think this is a good representation of like how you can kind of stilt matchups over the course of like, if you're playing many games with a team like this. I guess they can't knock me out with Heavy Slam, even with the Sword of Ruin active. And they can't Body Press me, so they have to get the Body Press and knock out the Amoongus for this play to backfire, instead of me just going for Reflect. And even then, we should be fine. But yeah, over the course of a very long Battle Stadium season, having moves like Origin, you're going to miss a lot of Origin Pulses, but if you can also put things like Thunder Wave in your favor over the course of many, many turns, you can, of course, significantly improve your odds over the course of a season. Like, we won this game definitely off of just the multiple paralysis we got into the Zamazenta, and we wouldn't... Oh, interesting. Life Orb. So they would have knocked themselves out regardless on the Chen Pao, so Raging Bolt should clean it up here. But yeah, going for the Thunder Wave turn one, I think was smart just because they had the Zebstrika in for the rest of the battle, so just prioritizing that. Oh my god. That is definitely very unfortunate for them. So at this point, we should just win on timer if we want to. I want to look at my speed stat to verify that we're going to outspeed them. I am running 103. I don't think Zamazenta can outspeed me. I'm not sure though. I'm pretty sure they won't outspeed. 103, Zacian gets to like 210 or something, or like 208, and Zamazenta is slower than that, so yeah, we do take the knockout. Finally getting ourselves a clean shot against the Zamazenta, despite the Zebstrika just being such a pain in our side, but that was a really cool team. They definitely, I mean, it's hard to say should have won like against Paralysis when you have it on the field so often, but... I really only had one opportunity to go for the Thunder Wave and they didn't stop it, so on some level, they're probably kicking themselves for not just going straight to the Zebstrika early on. So, good game to them, unlucky, but that tends to be how it goes with a team like this. Very influenced by RNG either way. Okay, we have Iron Bundle. This actually looks like the team that Zhe Zhang got, I think it was 9th place at a regional with in Los Angeles, so... Tera Grass on the Kyogre looks pretty strong here. Reflect, Light Screen, etc. looks good too. Gotta be wary of Fake Out on the Iron Hands though, that's kind of annoying. Raging Bolt could be cool. Let's think about going Kyogre lead with Rillaboom, and then if we get some Calm Minds up and we can avoid the Delibird, that could be solid. Munga seems pretty good. As well, maybe Incineroar as well could be good. Depends on if they're clear amulet or not. Might leave Screens on the bench here. Since I can intimidate the one, like Light Screen would be pretty high value though. If I could get that off. I think I will go for the first time just completely the Fake Out, Pivot, Spore, Rage Powder Core. Leave the Grimmsnarl on the bench. I don't think... So Thunderclap could be cool against the Iron Bundle. They're usually Focus Sash here though, so it's not that useful. And if they have Encore, they like catch me Thunderclapping, then they continue to just like lock me down. That would be a bit annoying. And then Miraidon is just like kind of flip-flop. It's like a bit of a coin flip on if they Draco or go for an electric move into you. A lot of the time. Okay, so we do at least clear away the terrain, which I'm happy about. I might just go for Calm Mind right off the bat. No Screen is quite annoying, unfortunately, but I think I do have a fairly safe Calm Mind U-turn this turn. Tera, Calm Mind. Rip the Band-Aid off, go for it, and then a good Wood Hammer. The slot coming in, which seems pretty solid. I think U-turn's stronger here, though. Get some free chip. It's most likely what on the Grimmsnarl that switches out. or maybe the Miraidon, I'm not sure. Let's chip the Miraidon down, or whatever is coming in on that slot. So it looks like a Tera of some kind. Draco Meteor can do a lot of damage here, but I think with the healing I should be fine. Yeah, Tera Electric, fair enough. I think that's more so to deal with... What is that for? I guess late game not being Ice Beamed, you can switch into Ice Beam safer, but now I can hit a Water-type move a lot easier into you, so... They might be relying a bit on damage here. I guess it makes sense, there's no guarantee I'm going to not go for Tera here. But they left me open to go for a Fake Out, which is interesting. Because I could have gone ahead way, way big this turn with Fake Out Calm Mind. Light Screen, fair enough. They are getting their own boost of sorts, and then we're going to see them Volt Switch out, probably on the Kyogre. We'll see how much that does. Oh, into the Rillaboom. Doesn't do a lot, and we'll get the U-turn off into a Pokemon. Anything but Iron Hands is pretty good. I think... Blank the Unrivaled, that is going to be the yeah, that's fine. U-turn should put it in, probably not in range of the Origin Pulse, but I can switch into my Incineroar. They're probably going to Encore me, but that is what we have the Amoongus for. Oh, that's probably a crit, yeah? No, it isn't, okay. Not a lot of bulk on that guy then. So Amoongus is very safe, I can Rage Powder away any damage, and go for Calm Minds. Yeah, that seems good. Unlikely to be a safety goggles anywhere, so I can go for the Calm Mind, I think, fairly safely and just like prime myself defensively to win the game. And go at it that route. So what's really important is that they've actually burned their Terastallization, so they can't go for something crazy like a Tera Grass Encore into me. That's not an option. Safety goggles would be annoying for sure. I guess we'll find out though. They are that could be kind of bad. Definitely loses me a lot of momentum, but they are Thunder Wave, fair enough. Definitely very annoying, but if I can get the second Calm Mind up, I think an Origin Pulse has a good chance to KO the Grimmsnarl, or at least get pretty close. Freeze Dry, fair enough. So no Encore, maybe? Interesting. That's tricky. I might have to sack the... Might have to sack a Pokemon here. I don't love that, though. I think I'm going to go Rage Powder. If I don't get paired, I'm in a great spot. If I do, then they can potentially Encore me this turn, but that would be a very... They'd be reading a Paralysis, essentially. Okay, if we hit the Origin Pulse, I think that's a KO into Grimmsnarl, but they're going to switch out the Iron Bundle. Interesting. So the best they can do is get a para this turn. The worst that happens is Landorus gets paralyzed. Cool, very nice. So if we hit one Pokemon, I'll be happy with this turn. RNG was going to be so crazy this turn. It could have gone a number of different ways. If we hit the we do double hit, very nice. And we knock out the Landorus, no offense from you, Landorus, and then the Grimmsnarl is now looking a little dicey. Maybe even in range of Grassy Glide. Like, I think my play is looking very nice. Just switching out into Grimmsnarl in turn. Or switching out into Rillaboom. So that is the Iron Bundle. I think I might just have a win with... If I don't get frozen, I probably just win. I think I'm going to protect and switch into the... probably Incineroar. No, I'm not sure. I'm going to go into the Nah, this is worse because if Miraidon comes in, that's kind of bad. But what I might be doing here is actually saying, okay, yeah, like, Miraidon's super annoying, but if I can just avoid getting Encored, the two Calm Minds should be sufficient to wall it out. Because it'll have to lock into Draco. So if I can avoid getting Encored, I might have a win here. Icy Wind. Okay, Icy Wind, Freeze Dry. We'll see if they're Hydro Pump, I guess. Otherwise, they're going to have problems against the Incineroar in the back. But yeah, good damage there. I think I am just going to Fake Out and Ice Beam the Grimmsnarl to deal with that. If they do that, do I lose? Maybe, maybe not. I think I should be fine. They have used their Tera. They're usually Tera Ghost on this team, so if they had that option, that'd be a little scary, but of course they Tera in turn one. And if they switch out the Grimmsnarl, I don't think they will. I think they'll just take the Thunder Wave. And if they do, there's a 75% chance I just get the Grimmsnarl right away. Oh, Reflect is interesting. Okay. So they expected me to... what? Go for Grassy Glide? I guess. Interesting. Yeah, I expect... maybe they think I'm high horsepower. That would be one really easy way to win the game. But at this point, I feel pretty safe about just going for Protect, switch to Incineroar. Grassy Terrain's off the field, they're going to activate their terrain, but if I can get my Incin in, they don't have priority locking. I just have to fake out their Iron Bundle, and then I'll win. Because if I basically can't be Encored into a Protect, I should just win. With the multiple Calm Mind boosts on the Kyogre. They do have screens up, have to keep that in mind, but that's fine. So this mode of the team looking pretty strong. Just full support for the Kyogre working out quite well here. And if they knock me out with a Tera Electric Electro Drift into my Incineroar, A-OK. If they go for a Draco Meteor or something, that's fine. They won't be able to take knockouts as easily in the late game, and I can just Grassy Glide clean up the Iron Bundle. Have to stall out Reflect to make that happen, though. Freeze Dry, I guess they don't have Encore at this point. No, I went for Ice Beam last turn. Boom, Draco into the Kyogre. Fair enough. If they go for that again, we should be fine. Should probably just go for a Ice Beam. Not risk a miss or anything. Should 2-hit KO, right? Not sure. If they Encore me, that could be bad too. Okay, they would have given me Ice Beam, which would have been a win if I hit that. But if they don't crit the Draco, we should be fine. And they miss. Okay. I guess that's better. They can't lock us in with Encore anymore. That should be fine. It's not even a 2-hit KO, unfortunate. I think everything stands the same. I should just be able to go for a switch out. I guess they can freeze dry me here, and that would be bad. But I think without Hadron Engine boost, I might have a chance to live with the Draco. Like a pretty good chance, as long as they don't have the Hadron Engine Electric Terrain boost active. They'd have to double into me and get the crit on one. Which is fine. Yep. Gonna see a freeze here. No, Draco. Yeah, we live that pretty handily. I think if they had gotten the crit, they would have KO'd though. But they couldn't both get the crit. Yeah, Ice Beam's fine. Now we just knock them out with a pretty simple Grassy Glide, I think. Maybe later in the game, but regardless, we should be good here. The angle here might just be switching out the Amoongus, getting it back in, and then eventually we'll have the Rillaboom in to go for a Grassy Glide outside of Reflect. They got that up pretty late, though, so that was smart of them. Light Screen ended. Ice Beam probably gets there then. Or at least it puts it in Grassy Glide range. So yeah, I just fake out Grassy... So, they're not going to play it out for the Draco Meteor crit. Which, fair enough, would have been a lot of things that have to go right for them to win there. To even get a shot at, like, cracking through my Rillaboom, because then I have both Incineroar and Amoongus to protect it, so it's going to be a hard battle for them. But I think that was a really good example of the Calm Mind Kyogre doing very well. Assault Vest Kyogre, I think, is generally decent into Miraidon, but the Calm Mind one is effectively a boosted Assault Vest after one turn, and with the healing from Leftovers and the option to go for Protect, it makes it a lot harder for them to deal with. As you saw there. So they have Gastrodon, which could be Stockpile or just like Yawn. Eternatus, which is typically Cosmic Power. I don't think Stored Power, but like Sludge Bomb, etc. Dynamax Cannon. Could be Nasty Plot for Rigorath. Screens on the Grimmsnarl. I wish I had Encore somewhere, that'd be really nice. I don't think I can very easily outstall the Eternatus. But if I get some because I have to go for Tera Grass in front of the Rillaboom, I want to be specific. What should I do? I could get a Draco Meteor off very early, potentially force a Tera. I do like that angle a bit. I don't think I'll need screens necessarily. Kyogre seems strong. And I think Incineroar is decent here. I don't really like Rillaboom that much. Well, maybe. I think being able to intimidate the Rillaboom should be good. But yeah, beating this Eternatus is going to be a pain and a half. For sure. Yeah, it's going to be quite difficult, I think. With the Gastrodon support, I'm really just hoping to force a Tera out early from them. If they lead Grimmsnarl, Eternatus, I have to pick a Spore target. I don't think I can afford to get Spirit Broken, but I might have to commit a Tera regardless in front of Dynamax Cannon, so it's a bit tricky. We'll see what we can do. Grimmsnarl, Eternatus, they might just go for Screen right off the bat, which would be fair enough. Yeah. Grass would be really annoying, honestly. We'll see. We will see. I might just have to commit to the Tera early. I don't know, maybe, maybe not. Draco Spore could be good. Certainly. The problem is they likely have Protect. Or Recover. So it's going to be hard to beat them, I think. Misty Terrain would be kind of crazy here, and like, honestly incredible. I might have to forfeit if they have that. Rocky Helmet get a bit of chip, very nice. They go for Cosmic Power, so we're going to hit the full power Draco on them. If I was Booster Energy, this would get very close to a KO. Unfortunately not the case. We're at least forcing them to go for a Recover next turn, which I'm happy about. Yeah, certainly forced to. They'll go for a Reflect next turn, which is fine. They are only boosting defenses. We might be able to outboost them with Calm Mind. Boom, out into the Kyogre, and I think I'm actually going to support the Grimmsnarl, because the Eternatus, although it does pose a threat, I think getting paralyzed or Spirit Broken poses a bit more of a threat. So let's handle that. Yeah, I haven't Terra'd yet, so that's good. I might be off base though. Getting Paro'd would stink, for sure. But getting the Spore off would be really valuable into Eternatus. Because then I can go for Calm Mind. Probably not even Knock Out. I'm going to go after the Eternatus. It's going to be hard. It depends on what the Grimmsnarl set is, truly. If it's Thunder Wave, then I probably shouldn't be going for this, but I don't know. They could also Spirit Break my Kyogre, which would be a lot of damage on Switch, unfortunately. Protect. Should have supported the Grimmsnarl. Fair enough. That's bad. Okay. Yikes. Parting Shot. Okay. Cool. That makes sense. I like that. I couldn't have supported the Grimmsnarl if they go to Rillaboom, so fair enough. Okay. So this gives them the opportunity to recover. If I was Cobra Cloak, that'd be pretty cute, but unfortunately not the case. Of course. Oh, I think it's so likely they don't Woodhammer here. So I kind of want to Calm Mind, but I think it's like kind of foolish to do so. They never got screens up. We'll only be at neutral. I don't think that makes sense. Yeah, they're leftovers. Fair enough. They're going to heal a lot of HP this battle. But we did see the Draco did over 50%. So I think I'm just going to go Incineroar on the Amoongus slot, I want to say is decent. Maybe double switch? I don't know. Having Spore Pressure active is very valuable, and I'm going to keep that up, I think. Because Cosmic Power is very scary, but I think they can only go up to 3 Cosmic Powers, if I'm not mistaken. And they're not boosting their special attack, so I don't... Are they Stored Power? I forget. Does this thing learn Stored Power? I do not remember at all. Pick out into the Amoongus, that's fine. I don't think they're ever going to let me Spore that Eternatus that easily, so... With that in mind, I might just go for a Fake Out. Spore into Rillaboom is decent. I could Parting Shot it as well. I think I don't mind Parting Shots for they might feel pretty safe on the Eternatus, honestly. So I'm going to go Parting Shot that and Spore the Rillaboom just in case they don't U-turn. Yeah, they're switching it out. So unless that's Incineroar, we are getting a Spore off this turn. Grimmsnarl, yeah, that's not safety goggles. There's no shot. So Parting Shot, Fake Out. Could be Taunt. Could be a lot of things. Yeah, cool. So we will get a Spore off into that slot, I want to say. Could have gone in the Rillaboom, gotten the Kyogre in pretty aggressively, but I think with Rain ending soon, we might want to have a bit of a delay on it. I'm not sure. If I can drop the damage on the Eternatus, that's a good start. This is going to be a slow battle, just if in case you weren't expecting that. Another one, actually. Okay, so we do play out of that situation well. We get a decent read and are now in a good enough spot. I can knock off the Eternatus, get a little bit less healing on them, which could be valuable. Let's do that, actually. Yeah, if I get the knockoff and the Spore, I can go for the Parting Shot in another turn. That healing is just so much. Dynamax Cannon. Cool, fair enough. You're not boosting your special attack, so I should live. Cool. And that's permanent damage on the Eternatus. We can go into the Raging Bolt if we want to and get rid of that. So if they were Tera Grass, I think they would have gone for it. So that does teach us a little bit about their set. I'm going to Parting Shot that slot and then probably Spore the Grimmsnarl. I don't know, maybe. I'm healing a lot on the Incineroar, which is appreciated. I could get back to full HP, that'd be cool. Parting Shot, and then... I get back to full HP, that's good. I don't think they're going to Spirit Break my Amoongus here. And I want the HP back. So no switch out from the Grimmsnarl, it's probably a Parting Shot. If they're Parting Shotting anything, they're nailing my Amoongus, which is the issue. Because I won't be able to Draco them as easily. But yeah, getting the knockoff means I could knock them out with Draco, maybe not. But they don't wake up this turn. Or they didn't go for Parting Shot, at least. So this is an opportunity to go for a Spore, I think. Or bring the Amoongus back in and keep the pressure on. Or go for a Calm Mind, I'm not sure. Let's go Amoongus, though. Keep the HP high on the Kyogre and not get Spear Broken, that would be really annoying. Stays fast asleep, that is good. That is very good. I think they've only burned one turn of sleep on the Eternatus, so we have the Draco active. And... yeah, that's good. I do just like Rage Powder Spore here. Grassy Terrain is gone. Let's just get that off. So the important thing is the damage we've taken is not permanent, and the stuff that they are taking is, like, semi-permanent. Draco, we'll see if they live this or not. They stay asleep, so they would have gone for a Parting Shot, maybe. And they stay asleep. Okay, if we hit the Draco, it's going to be very close to a knockout. Might be a little shy, though. Oh, yeah, we do get there. The knockoff damage, I think, was very essential. Not going for Parting Shot initially. Stopping at least one additional turn of Black Sludge was very important, I think, based on the initial Draco damage. So, yeah, we knock out the Restricted, and we've basically taken damage on none of our Pokemon. Gastrodon the Well-Trained. Probably not well-trained enough to deal with the Kyogre in the back. I'm just going to Spore the Gastro and switch out into Kyogre. Because although I'm likely to take an Earth Power in that slot... Basically, I'm likely to take an Earth Power in that slot, and I don't want my Kyogre or my Incineroar taking that. Damage on the Incineroar, HP on the Incineroar is going to be very premium against the Rillaboom if they have high host power. So, yeah, Parting Shot into the Grimmsnarl or into the Kyogre slot, fine with me. I was really expecting Rillaboom to come in this turn, but it's important to me that I get the Incineroar in next turn after I've gotten the Spore off this turn. Because then I can Parting Shot the Gastro and basically ignore it. We'll see if they're goggles, that would complicate things a little bit, but I think their damage is pretty lacking against the Raging Bolts. Cool, there's the Ice Beam, hoping for a freeze, I guess. Good play. Really good play. Okay. Oh, we do thaw out. That's very lucky. Very lucky turn for us, but lucky turn for them too, so. coin goes both ways. I think at this point we could just lock the Tera Grass on the... yeah, I think Tera Grass lock is correct. Yep, yep, yep. I think Incineroar is very safe. They'd have to crit a U-turn at this point. Is there any... What else am I tearing? Tera Electric's not good. I mean, it's fine. It's okay. Tera Grass gives them a super effective hit on me. I'll go for it. Wait, did I actually hit it? I'm not sure. I had it highlighted, but I don't know if I actually went for the Tera Grass. And we won't live if we just switch the Incineroar in, so we might have just sacked, unfortunately. Based on a misclick. Which can happen. Oh no, we went for it. Cool. So now, Woodhammer we're not in danger of. U-turn could be in danger of. I don't remember if they went for U-turn or not. I think they hard switched the Rillaboom that one turn. But yeah, if they have U-turn, they can't really beat the Incineroar that easily. Knockoffs, interesting. So good read there. We're going to lose a bit of healing, but I think with the Calm Mind going up, we're in a decent spot regardless. We can fake out the Gastro, get another Calm Mind up if we want it, or just Ice Beam the Rilla twice. I could Ice Beam the Gastro, though, which would be decent. Let's fake out the Gastro, or knock it off. If I knock off the AB, I'm in a good spot. Let's just fake out. And Ice Beam the Rillaboom. Get some damage off of that. It could go for a Tera, which makes sense, but I'm happy to burn that, for sure. Okay. Tera Fire, that's fine. Once Gastrodon goes down, I can wipe the board with Origin Pulse. Their damage into my... Once I Parting Shot the Gastrodon, their damage into Amoongus is very limited. Drum Beating. Okay. I actually like that play a fair bit. So that might... We'll look at the speed tiers here. That might let their Gastrodon outspeed my Incin, but the Ice Beam damage is going to be pretty minimal under Rillaboom. We do get our first chance to freeze, like they got into us. We'll see about that turn, though. Paying attention to the grassy terrain healing, the Kyogre. The Gastrodon does heal first. That is challenging. I think I'm going to switch out into my Amoongus just because I do not want... Like, I can take an Ice Beam. I'm totally fine with them going for that or even knock-offing me. What I really can't afford to do is let them knock out my Incin. It is just such a good wall. If I can Parting Shot the Gastrodon, I can really limit their damage output. And now I get an Origin Pulse for a knockout into the Rillaboom. I'm sort of forced to go for it, unfortunately. They will get the Storm Drain boost, of course, but yeah, I kind of have to just play with that. I could have Ice Beam the Gastro, I guess. Maybe that's a bit smarter. I don't rely on a miss here. I don't rely on hitting. But I wasn't sure if that was a 2-hit KO. We do hit, so that should be GG. They never got Light Screen up, and now their main offensive and defensive output is gone. But they would pretty much just have to make a read here on this switch. Gastrodon does wake up. Very nice, but they go for the Earth Power incorrectly. Big damage from the plus one Gastro, though. So at this point, we're looking to lock the game 100%, so probably not hitting Origin Pulses unless we can't help it, absolutely. So Ice Beam is going to be our best friend here. Rage Powder? I mean, I guess the problem is that they have Fake Out. So we'll stop that for a turn, and probably just go for Rage Powder Ice Beam into the Gastro. And once we have Fake Out active again, we can knock that out with two Ice Beams, I think. I think this game could have gotten tricky if I'd missed the Origin Pulse, so I should have just gone for the Ice Beam, given the Rillaboom is only threatening like Drum Beatings and knockoffs in my Tera Grass Kyogre. The Gastrodon is the only threat. If I give it a special attack boost and it starts getting freezes with Ice Beam, then Earth Power Ice Beam is kind of dangerous coverage. So no rain, but no healing from grassy terrain. Seems favorable to me. It's a very grindy game against Eternatus there. That's the problem with Eternatus, though. Unless you get the cosmic powers to the point where you can just, like, outstall Oh, that did nothing. Wow, okay. The Rocky Helmet damage is going to be nice, but that damage was really pathetic. Boom, big Rocky Helmet chip. I guess the problem is... I wonder if knockoff... I'm trying to avoid having to go for Draco Meteor. I think it's Incineroar here regardless, because I don't have to play around with the Spirit Break mind games. Leftovers is annoying, yikes. Okay. I am at full HP, and Grimmsnarl's damage output is kind of pitiful. So what I could go for is Fake Out Calm Mind. Boost the special defense a bit. I think that is my best play, potentially. Fake Out, Calm Mind, boost a little bit. If they freeze me, can I lose? For sure, yeah. They can't really win with the Spirit Break play necessarily. Even if they crit, I'm going neutral at least, and on special defense I'm going positive, and their Grimmsnarl damage is pretty limited with a minus one against the Incin. Ooh, Parting Shot. No Spirit Break, maybe? Or were they expecting me to attack? That definitely is going to keep me at very low special attack, but at least I can go for offensive options. Or defensive boost, so Ice Beam is going to do a bit less, but I can at least get hits off. Maybe I Parting Shot. Yeah, giving up the boost is like kind of dicey here, right? Plus one special attack is super scary. I think if they go for that, I'll live with the... This kind of tips off they might not have Spirit Break, there might be Foul Play on the Grimmsnarl, so I should have the free switch out into the Raging Bolt. Earth Power is going to probably 2-hit KO me, but it at least won't knock out my Incineroar in subsequent turns, so I'll be able to apply Fake Out pressure. And if they go for... What does it have to be, like, Spirit Break? I feel like they don't, otherwise you go for it that turn. Kind of confused by the not going Spirit Break, that just feels a lot better. They have it, interesting. I don't really follow that play, truthfully, but they didn't Spirit Break the Raging Bolt, so that's all I care about. Viz Earth Power into the Raging Bolt, and they don't crit, fair enough. At this point, we should just be able to start doubling into the Grimmsnarl. This game ended up being very close just because I didn't bring the Rillaboom to deal with the Gastro, but that is fine. The damage in the Gastro is kind of missing here, huh? I guess we go Thunderbolt Calm Mind still. Let's just go Ice Beam. Could be Protect to deal with the Draco or Parting Shot into the Raging Bolt. Both would be fine. But I think what I really want is just to get some damage into the Grimmsnarl, so I can Fake Out Ice Beam it and then try and close the game consistently. Three battles, three turns left. I think we win on HP here. Another battle going to time on this team. Crazy. And there is the Ice Beam. Does a lot. Thunderbolt should chip it in range with the Fake Out. Yeah, Fake Out itself might knock out here, so we're in good shape. Recover. A-OK by me, bud. So Protect, no Yawn, I have to imagine. Boom. Thunderbolt into... You. I don't think there's really need to like try and timer stall this necessarily, so I'm going to go for a Ice Beam. Yeah, lowering my special attack at this point does not matter. They have to get Ice Beam crits, I think. And then I should have enough of your time to close regardless. Ooh, guess I should have gone for... I should have looked at my speed tiers here. I wasted a Draco turn. Unfortunate. It is what it is, though. Boom, Earth Power KO, 2 minutes left. We'll look at our time. I think we don't have to stall this out. With animation times, we should be sufficient. We should have it with Protect. Because they have to crit Earth Power into Incin, and then we should have enough Ice Beam damage to knock out the Gastro. And knock off. Should get us there as well. Boom, Protect. Good play, my friend. But unfortunately, knock off Ice Beam with enough your time will win me the game. As long as there's 45 seconds at the end of the next turn, after knock off Ice Beam goes off, we will win. I mean, even then we can protect the Kyogre. No, actually, because they have recover. We can't do that so consistently. But we have enough of your time to close this out, I think. So we will do so. Wait till it gets to at least 45 seconds. Or not. At least till we see the 1 minute. Yeah. We have too much of your time for them to sufficiently win. We'll let it go to 50. This animation's going to take more than 5. Yep, very nice. And then knockoff should be enough. And we freeze just to boot. Yeah, if they had kept the Amoongus frozen, it could have been kind of scary. But I think we definitely rolled pretty lucky this match. We hit the Origin Pulse, thawed out. And yeah, they stay frozen. Unfortunate. And they disconnect. Yeah. That's kind of just them being salty unless they don't know the timer strats. Or the timer tiebreaker. Because we did win that game. Regardless of who they crit, we have more HP and we have enough here time to close the final seconds of the battle on a timer win. Okay, hoping to close out the undefeated streak here. We have Grimmsnarl, Ursaluna, Ferrigraph, Volcarona, plus Miraidon, Whimsicott. I think outside of Cobra Cloak Encore could be very annoying for our Kyogre, but I think if we just delay Calm Minds until Whimsicott is off the field, that should be fine. Screens seem good. I don't mind just leading with the Rillaboom, get terrain off the field. I don't think screens benefit me that much here. Intimidate could be good for sure. Screens could be good. Is it going to be more valuable than Moongus though? I kind of doubt it. It could be though. It could let me stall out the Volcarona, but if they're Terra Grass, that's bad. I should be able to outstall them if they're Terra Grass Giga Drain, if they're Terra Grass. Otherwise, it could be a problem. But I think I will go with this. I don't think Grimmsnarl's value is as high as the rest of the Pokemon's utility. Like, screens are very good. Special screens, like Light Screen right off the bat is going to wall everything except for the Grimmsnarl and the other guy. And I can't really Thunder Wave things that easily. Moonblast, Volt Switched, all doing a ton to me, so I don't love the Grimmsnarl's position defensively here. I might just get one screen and then get knocked out, whereas the rest of the Pokemon can switch in or leave the field a couple of times. If they are Focus Sash on the Whimsicott, and they're not Terra Ghost, if they burn Terra early, we could lock it down with Fake Out. It's just hard to figure out what they are. Okay, Grimmsnarl, that's totally fine. They could Thunder Wave me, which would be like pretty annoying, but fine. This does feel like an immediate Calm Mind angle to me, though. Fake out the Grimmsnarl plus Calm Mind seems very strong. And I'm not Wood Hammering and Origin Pulsing because I think that might be a little slow to start for me. They could Terra Ghost here reasonably, but I think they probably want to preserve a Terra this battle. Because what that accomplishes is, I guess, they get a Spirit Break or a Thunder Wave off, which doesn't seem that good. I think Terra Grass would be way better on the Volc here. We just have to figure out if they're Bug Buzz or not, which I think, given we have Rillaboom on the field, if they Quiver Dance this first turn, they're probably going to go for that the next turn. But taking a lot of time, I feel like this would be a pretty simple turn for them. If it's a Rage Powder Volc, we're in an awesome spot. Struggle Bug would be a little annoying, but we're at least getting the Special Defense boost, which would be cool, and we do see a Terra from them. Grass would be annoying. Water would be fine. It is water. Okay, that's a clean Wood Hammer next turn. Very, very easy for me. Yep, get the Fake Out off. We'll see what they were going for. No way to determine, and it is Quiver Dance. So if they're Bug Buzz, that's kind of a little scary, but that's fine. I don't know if plus one Bug Buzz knocks out Rillaboom. I'm probably just going to go for a Wood Hammer Origin Pulse here, or another Calm Mind, I think. Yeah, let's go Calm Mind, I think, for sure. Seems solid. They're going to get a screen up. They might switch out. Maybe, maybe not. I could Ice Beam the Grimmsnarl slot, but I think a screen is much more likely. We'll go Wood Hammer, and I think we will hold off on going for the Terra Fire, because they have to be a very specific set. Bug Buzz, which I think Giga Drain is more common. I'm not certain of that, though. if they're Giga Drain, they're kind of in a bad way here because neutral Giga Drain is not going to do that much to Kyogre. A lot of it I'm going to heal back with Leftovers and Grassy Terrain. Switch out on the Grim, so they were trying to bait out the Grassy Terrain. So worst case, I get a Calm Mind and my Rillaboom goes down, which would stink. But I think I am reasonably bulky on the Rillaboom. There's a chance I live if they are Bug Buzz regardless. Protect, that's totally fine. I'll take that second Calm Mind for sure. Okay. That is fine by me. They're going to Volt Switch out, most likely. Am I okay with that? I could have Ice Beam that for a probably not knockout, but pretty close, unfortunately. This play gets a little scary. I kind of want to Calm Mind again, but surely I just go for the Grass Terra, I think. They've already Terra'd. I think I'll live the hit. I'm going to go Origin Pulse or Ice Beam. Let's go Ice Beam. I like Opal Switch, truthfully, to Amoongus. Because Rillaboom's looking quite strong here, defensively. Electrodrift, it really might... Oh no, Electrodrift has the added bonus of doubling, in, like having an additional boost into... When you hit it, super effect. Oh my god, they were only Flamethrower, that stinks. Okay, they drift into the Rillaboom, which was... You know, makes sense, but I don't think would have knocked out on Assault Vest. But yeah, we lose the Amoongus. I think that's a fair trade if we hit here. And even if we don't, I think that's fine. Because now we know that they are not that. We O-Pulse and we do double miss. Okay. Seen worse turns, but seen better. So that's fine. Yeah, that's obviously bad, but it is what it is. I think what I want to do here is actually go for an Origin Pulse again? Maybe Ice Beam into the Miraidon? Are they trying to Electro Drift me? I'm going to Origin Pulse, I think, and U-turn. My Kyogre? Let's get saucy. This is the last battle, after all. Now that miss stunk because I could probably knock out the Volc with U-turn now. But we see the Miraidon switch out. They're trying to get terrain dominance. They don't have a knockout on the Rillaboom, and what comes in will most likely get knocked out. So I'm U-turning because if this guy goes down to a Protect, I actually want Fake Out active on the board. And that's what I think we're going to get here. If we hit. And if we don't, we should heal the damage mostly back with the Leftovers and Grassy Terrain. And we'll have Fake Out active the next turn. Cool, we knock out the Grimmsnarl. Very nice. Would have been cool to have gotten the damage off on the Volc because we can go for a Grassy Glide instead of a U-turn, or a Grassy Glide instead of a Wood Hammer, but, you know, we take what we can get. So out into the Incineroar, swagging on them a little bit. Unfortunately, we don't get that much value out of it. Rain's going to end soon, and then they'll be able to pin me with Electro Drift, unfortunately. I need to run the Calc. I don't think I can live an Electro Drift at plus 2, I have to imagine. If I was at plus 3, I think I would, but unlikely. Have to be wary of Verbraff, though. Let's think. One more turn of rain. Did they knock me out or not? I think they probably do. Kyogre, Electro Drift. Yeah, they do. Well, terrain? How about grassy terrain? Grassy terrain I have a chance to live, but I don't think it's pretty high. I think my best play is actually just Terra Grass Switch this turn. Fake Out. And let them take the knockout. I did leave my Kyogre open last turn. No, this is kind of a throw, right? Yeah, this probably should have been Fake Out Miraidon and hope they don't have Photograph in the back. I have one turn of rain left, and that might be very bad for me. Because they're boosted up, if they knock out my Incineroar here, they probably win the game. And we Ice Beamed and didn't Origin Pulse. Yikes, okay. And we've gone for Terra Grass. Oh! Looking bad. We'll see who comes in. But I think with the plus... Oh, that's gone. Plus two Ice Beams getting that. Boom. We'd love to see it. And... I need to look up the calc on the... on Volcarona, our least favorite guy. If we had hit Origin Pulse, we would have the Grassy Glide KO, but that's not the game state we're playing, so... can't complain too hard about it. They only have one Quiver Dance, so we knock out the Miraidon still, and then probably win. With Rillaboom in the back. I just have to make sure of that. So, made what was probably a simple game state a lot harder than it had to be, because they did not have Ferrigraph in the back. But that is the beauty of the Pokemon, right? Plus one versus plus two. Unless they crit, they should knock out with Flamethrower. If they do, well, you know, they got me. They have to lock in a Draco Meteor, I think. And that's going to be sufficient drops to probably be fine here. Should I attack? Should I Parting Shot? Probably just Parting Shot. Yeah, they go Quiver Dance, interestingly enough, giving me turns with the Rillaboom later on. Okay, I think you kind of had to go for the crit there, but if you knock Dazzling Gleam, that's not right. Like, you have to go for a knockout on Incin or Kyogre this turn. Getting the Parting Shot off is devastating here. Because not only do I get the Parting Shot off, I get active Fake Out Pressure if I want it. Boom, back down to neutral. You do get the special defense boost, but that is fine by me. I am getting to the point where I actually do not need Kyogre's boost anymore. I think I'm not there yet, but I should be able to go for a Grassy Glide Calm Mind, I think. Should be sufficient. We'll see. Fake Out Grassy Glide feels incorrect. I could Fake Out Switch Woodhammer. They're effectively neutral in rain with the Flamethrowers. I don't know. I think we just play the Boost War, most likely. Plus two special defense, plus one special attack. Ice Beam's not doing a lot, is it? Let's just go Calm Mind Grassy Glide, I think. Or Fake Out. I think I'm gonna go Fake Out, actually. They have to get the burn, and then even then I think I still 1v1 them. Fake Out damage is solid, and they have to get the burn. They don't get the burn, so we start getting ahead in the Calm Mind War, which means we don't have to go for Origin Pulses, we can just go for Ice Beams. And without getting the burn, Grassy Glide Ice Beam should be a KO. Sometimes you do just have to start playing towards what is likely, and what was likely was us not getting burned and having a pretty easy endgame here. I think no reason to attack or Calm Mind again. We do have a pretty big Calm Mind lead. We're plus three to their plus two. So two Ice Beams should get us there, and even if it doesn't, we get Fake Out the following turn. So I think the U-turn, yeah, they cancel out. I think the U-turn to get Fake Out active again really put them on the back foot. Got in a bit of a bad position there. Basically letting the... not going for Ice Beam on Miraidon. If I go for Ice Beam, I think I just win on the spot pretty easily. But because I didn't go for that, I had to play a little bit... I couldn't really switch out my Kyogre as easily because I needed something to handle the Miraidon more proactively. And the... Tera Grass, Calm Mind, Boosted, Ice Beams were all that I really had, so probably needed to be going for Ice Beams earlier. I think a lot of this team is just recognizing when you need to be hitting your Ice Beams. Like, I think it's easy to just go for your Origin Pulses, and if you're hitting them with your plus one, plus twos, you're going to be doing well, but knowing when you can just go for an Ice Beam instead has been the main takeaway here in my battles, is definitely the main point where you can optimize your play with this team to not be so reliant on accuracy. So that is going to do it for Battles Today, featuring Crystal, Jeongso Lee's, ninth place at the Victory Road $2,000 cash prize tournament, as well as first place and third place in the June Battle Stadium rankings. Definitely congratulations to them on a very impressive feat. I think they were like literally one elo point away from getting, I guess it was two, the person ahead of them was ahead by one. If they had won one more battle, they would have been two elo ahead of them and would have been first and second place on the ladder, which to my knowledge, hasn't been done in a long time. Maybe UB Slow has done it and I'm not aware of it, but definitely would have been a very impressive feat. Overall, a very cool team. We've been seeing it pop up in a lot of online tournaments as well as ladder, so something to get familiar with. Of course, if you want to do so yourself, on Pokemon Showdown, I have the EV spreads in the description below. My recreation, Crystal, did not share the team online, as well as the rental code in the top right. Again, my creation and game. If you appreciate the resource of these videos, of these teams, please subscribe to the channel. And with all that being said, peace, y'all.